If you can hear birds a lot during this video, that's because there are birds doing things in this video. I am coming at you from the floor of my parents' house because it is Sunday of spring break and I have 6 days to make a dress. The only problem is it's not for me, so I don't have any patterns that are already made to me. Would you shut up? And also, I don't have all the time in the world to edit this video, so it's gonna be vlog style, which is something I haven't tried before. It's a prom dress for my little sister. I got a call from my mom about 2 days ago, and she started asking me questions about, oh, well, when do you think you're gonna get in for spring break, and how long will you be staying, and are you staying with us, are you staying with your sisters? And then she said, oh, and while you're here, you can make your sister's prom dress, right? So I am making a prom dress. I have it designed somewhere. I'll get that in a second. But I'm looking forward to it. I think it's gonna be an adventure. And so I'll see how it goes. Drawing of the dress. This is what me and my sister agreed upon to design. But it is a sheer illusion neckline with a bustier covered top and a long tulle and organza skirt that goes down into greenery and little rosebuds all over it. It's inspired by the works of Teyuta Matoshi. I will put some of her stuff here. Who is the sister of Lyrica Matoshi, who is infamous for making the strawberry dress. So this is gonna be a very like woodland fantasy vibe. And so I'm looking forward to it. And now it is time to draft a pattern. I have some idea of what I'm doing for a pattern. So what I did was I found a bra that fits. And I am using this as a basis for the wire for the cup because I'm going to recycle it out of this. And then I used two dresses that my sister has, one with sleeves, one without sleeves, one with a little bit of give, one without a little bit of give. And I took some measurements off of that to get a waist measurement and an underbust measurement. And so the waist measurement is less than the underbust measurement. So I made little cuts out of it to give it some shape. And then I made the arms eye, since there's no top, it's going to have straps and an illusion. It just has this underarm scoop going up to the back. And in the center back, I'm going to add an extra panel of fabric with a zipper. But then at this line here on the pattern, I'm going to add lacing. Excuse me. Oh, I sneeze like a dad. So this is the center front, so everything on this will be doubled on the other side. And then within the cups, I am going to use the bra cups I have to create another pattern for the cup in fabric, but I am also going to insert the foam cups and sew it into the lining of the dress. And so now I am going to use this old pair of khakis that my dad had me make into shorts for him. So I just have some of the fabric laying around and I'm going to make a mock-up using this pattern and I am going to try and pattern one of the cups. I almost forgot to show y'all this neat hack. So I drew this all on a whiteboard, but to transfer it with an actual pattern, I'm just putting parchment paper for cooking over the whiteboard and tracing it on here. You can also do this with tracing paper, but I draw it on the whiteboard because it lets me erase and remake my marks really fast instead of trying to do this on paper. Update, I drew out the pattern on this bra and then used this to create a pattern for the cups of the bodice that I will put together and attach to the mock-up I have so far. So each of the cups will go here and here, and then tomorrow I'll be able to try it on my sister and do a fitting. Okay, so we just got back from the store and we bought lots and lots of pink things. So we got pink thread, we got pink ribbon, pink bias tape. I even made sure the zipper is pink. And then also we got a lot of, wow, this is bright on camera. We got pink organza, and then we also, well, no, that's pink chiffon. Yeah, that's chiffon. And then we also got pink organza. And then we also got pink poly satin. So we got a lot of pink, right?
Yeah, I think like a total of like almost 20 yards.
20 yards of pink.
Pink.
Car looks like it was bathed in Pepto-Bismol. Blush and bashful. Two very distinct shades of pink. So, now we have to actually make a dress.
I have to go inside and start on this dress at some point, but figured I'd spend some time with Pepper before then. Yeah. Yeah. Because Pepper has black hair, as you can see, and sheds a lot. So a pink dress with a lot of... What? Are you okay? A pink dress with a lot of static-y material means that I'm gonna have to keep her out of the room where I'm working in. So I'm gonna miss you for the next few days. You crackhead.
Okay, so I'm cutting out the pieces and I'm realizing this is kind of why I don't make dresses for people who aren't me a lot of the time, because I am very corner cuttery in the fact that like almost nothing I make actually fits me everywhere. Like, it fits me in the places that matter, and everything else I just make well enough to where it looks good. But like, I'm making this for my little sister and I keep thinking like, oh, I gotta double check this measurement and do this, this, and that to where it's perfect, and like, I actually took the effort to draw out all of my pattern lines. I have not done that in so long, and I'm doing them individually. Usually, I'll cut into like four layers of fabric just to get it done quicker, because I don't have time. And it's so nice, because my parents are paying for this dress, because it's her prom dress. But that means that like, I don't have to pay for the fabric, and it's spring break. I have time to make a dress. So like, this is amazing.
Okay, this is monstrous lighting, but instead of the patterned cups, I gathered some and I really like the way this looks. And I'm in charge here, so I'm gonna make it like this.
So this bra, I'm tired. This bra that I've been using as a reference apparently is too big, because apparently you don't know how to buy and wear a bra that fits you.
It was a
hand-me-down. You don't wear hand-me-down bras. That's disgusting. Okay, anyway, so I'm going to have to take it in bra-wise and fix this.
All right, I am starting to take strips of ribbon, singe the edges with a lighter. Ugh, I've got the hiccups. And I am going to sew along each edge of the ribbon to create channels for boning. Okay, so I have all the ribbon channels put in, and I'm going to put zip ties in all of this. But before I do that, I'm going to be taking fabric and just putting a lining in here so that it's all nice, and I really just want it to match the colors. There's nothing wrong with leaving it like this, but I want it to be pink. So I'm gonna make it pink. All right, so the zip ties are in. I have bound the edges of this. I finished lining this and finishing up the front of it, and I went ahead and put some binding on the edge of it. And so now, I get to connect the two. Also, I'm gonna add some more of this binding to the bottom edge.
I'm currently making the straps for the dress, and pulling this out feels like I'm like gutting someone because it's pink. It's like I'm handling a silky large intestine. I have a checklist of things for me to do today, and the first things I'm going to be doing are I'm going to be attaching these straps to the inside of the bodice so that I can do a fitting with them later. My little sister is gone right now, so I can't have a fitting with her until later this evening, because she is taking care of someone's pet rabbit, I think. But I did also add these to the back. And so these are the loops
which the lacing will run through. And so I'm just going to run a line of stitching right next to this ribbon to attach all the loops on. And I will come back on here and update you after that. Straps have been sewn on. The lacings have been attached. And so I'm taking a break from the actual piece of the bodice. I went ahead and attached a ruffle and got this underskirt put together. So I just need really, I don't know if you can see in the mirror, got this, not on it today. This underskirt put together, I need a waistband for it. So next steps are to cut this pink fabric to make one, a waistband, and two, a very, very long tube that I can use as lacing for this bodice. On to that. I'm just going through and ironing the waistband and all the lacing I just made. So my sister is still not back, and I still can't try the top of the dress on her to see if it fits. So until then, I have just started working on a petticoat sort of layer to it. It's not huge. I just want it to give a little bit of shape to it. So I am just going through and ironing and hemming strips upon strips upon strips of organza. Lots of organza. All these strips are going to be sewn and gathered together to be puffy. I forgot to do an update at the end of today, and so now I'm just by this air mattress waiting for a load of towels so I can wash my hair, which is the greasiest it's been in a long time. I have 2 more days to make this dress, so 48 hours from about now. My hope is, since I got started on the petticoat today, and also I did a try-on of the bodice with my little sister, I got the straps pinned in place, and we decided to not put the zipper panel in. It's just gonna be the lacing on the back, so that's one less step. So tomorrow, I really, really want to get all of the skirt finished. I have the underskirt, I have layer one of the petticoat. Now I need to make layer two, and then the overskirt. So I'm just hoping to get that all put together tomorrow. It's mostly a lot of hemming. So it's gonna be boring, but you know, it's the work that needs to be done. I have been gathering tulle for what feels like forever. Well, organza, not tulle. I have been gathering this for what feels like forever, but it's coming together, all the ruffles. I'm almost done with the petticoat and the underskirt, and the bodice is actually finished, except for the illusion top thing, but I'm not counting that as part of the bodice, so I get to say the bodice is finished. The skirt. I have this, which consists of the underskirt and the petticoat. And I ended up only using, I made 2 petticoats, and I only used 1 layer because I didn't want it to be too fluffy. And so it looks ridiculous on me because I'm like a foot taller than my sister, but for the most part, let me see if I can. Hey, Chucky. We're filming for a future
YouTube video.
Okay, so yeah, puffy pink marshmallow. For the overskirt, I'm going to be gathering and putting together 8 yards of chiffon, but I got it stuck on my head. I have already hemmed all of the chiffon, so it's really just a matter of cutting and gathering it and putting it into a waistband, much like this. We have a before and an after on the chiffon skirt. It started out as a big rectangular tube, nothing on it, and then I added a ribbon to act as a waistband for now, and at the top of the skirt I pleated it, and it holds up. Oops, I'm not good at holding this camera. It holds up pretty well for shape, but like I said, you can still see through it, so I'm gonna add another layer of the chiffon and then attach it to the petticoat, and I will see you then.
but I'm just holding it because it's a bit bigger than me. I've got two layers of chiffon, a petticoat, and an underskirt. Petticoat and underskirt. So, four layers of fabric gives a nice bell shape, twirls, very princessy. And so then it's just got this top that I've already fitted to my sister. And so now the only thing left is to do the illusion neck and to add a bunch of flowers.
I completely forgot to film any of the progress we're making. So you saw the dress as it was, but now we're doing sheer stuff over it. And so I've basically just been pinning it straight onto her. And then I'm going to tack this with hand sewing onto the dress. So that it has sort of a sheer thing. I'm gonna cut it here at the straps and then add a sleeve. I think I'm gonna go for like a butterfly kind of sleeve. We'll see how we feel about that, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe.
You're the same strength, you know better than I do.
I do. And I'll show you when that's done.
Okay, I got distracted working on it and it's late and I leave in the morning to go back to school, so I have to finish this tonight. So what I have for the dress is I covered it in sheer, went ahead and stitched that all down, added some little sleeves, just half circles sewn on, and then I'm starting to tack on the fake plants, and I'm just going through and whip stitching them on. And I'm gonna start at the waistline because I think that's the most important place for them. After that, I'm gonna go up along the bust line, and then if I have time, I wanna add some to the skirt. I probably won't have time for the skirt, waistline first. And just for reference, these are all the florals and things I'm working with. I have more than this, but this is what I've got set out. We have leaves, flowers, ferns, and some vine sprig things. Okay, here's how it's looking. I'm very happy with it. I sewed on the base leaves, but what I'm doing now is I'm putting dots of glue, not on the dress, but on just the plastic so that I can put more leaves on top of that and fill in. And I'm pretty happy with how it's going. These ones are finished up here and they've got lots of foliage and flowers on them. And I think it's looking pretty nice.
I did it. I've done as much as I can before needing to go to sleep. If I can get up early and do more, I will. But it is what it is. This is the dress so far. We have the bodice with the waist details, neckline, and then on the back of the dress, we have that on sides of the lacing, and then all around the base of the dress is some greenery. I want to put more greenery around the base, but I really don't have time, so we'll see.